There's a reason some call it the UEFA Cristiano League, and it's because of this guy.
Cristiano Ronaldo! I think he's got it! A hat-trick for Cristiano!
He won everything, broke so many records along the way. But the real question is, just how good was Ronaldo in the Champions League? It's his favorite competition. Ronaldo's Champions League career dates back to his first club, Sporting Lisbon. He was still trying to make a name for himself in the game when he made his debut for Sporting in a Champions League qualifying match versus Inter Milan in 2002. He didn't know it then, but this was the start of something special. Sporting lost 2-0 on aggregate and didn't get to play in the Champions League that year. But by the following campaign, Ronaldo was making his debut in the group stage of the competition with another club, Manchester United. He didn't play in the 5-0 match win over Panathinaikos, but when he finally did get to start for United, he showed he could cut it. He grabbed the assist for United's only goal in the 2-1 defeat against Stuttgart. He played 5 Champions League games in total for United in his first season, but they got knocked out of the competition by eventual winners Porto. At the time, the Ronaldo the world knows now wasn't the same player. He was more full of tricks and skills than end product, and as a result, his game time in big matches was a mixed bag. But at the start of the next season, Ronaldo hit it from the off on match day 1. He bagged 2 assists in the opening game versus Olympique Lyon. In the second group stage game versus Fenerbahce, Ronaldo took a back seat, because while he played the entire 90 minutes on the bench, another rising star stole the show. Wayne Rooney scored a hat-trick against Fenerbahce. Ronaldo's first 3 Champions League seasons were nothing to write home about. 1 goal and 2 assists in 12 Champions League games, he couldn't even pin a starting spot in the team. Once again, the round of 16 was the final bus stop for United, this time getting knocked out by AC Milan. And if you think his 2004-05 season was bad, the next one was even worse. In 6 games, he had more yellow cards than goal contributions. There was nothing to indicate that Ronaldo was destined to dominate the Champions League at that moment. But by the 2006-07 season, Ronaldo improved, and it showed in the numbers too. 3 goals and 5 assists in 11 games. See, Sir Alex Ferguson had now opted for a more fluid approach in United's attack this term, meaning Ronaldo wasn't just confined to the right wing. He had the freedom to get into decent goal-scoring positions, and it started paying off. United did way better than they had in previous campaigns. They reached the semifinals, only to get knocked out by AC Milan again. But in the following season, I don't think anyone, not even Ronaldo, would have been prepared for what happened next. 2007-08 Cristiano Ronaldo doesn't need too many words. Bangers. Ronaldo was on a different level that campaign. He went from struggling to get past the 10-goal mark in the Premier League a few seasons back to breaking the record for the most goals in a single season with 31. His form didn't just end in the league too. In the Champions League, Ronaldo was equally as impressive. He scored the decisive goal in the opening game of the Champions League season versus Sporting, and from that moment on, it all just clicked for him. By the time the group stages were over, Ronaldo had bagged 6 goal contributions in 5 games. Playing down the left wing, he combined goal scoring with dribbling and taking on defenders. He scored back-to-back in the round of 16 second leg versus Lyon and quarterfinal first leg versus AS Roma. United beat Barcelona 1-0 on aggregate to advance to the final of the competition. And in the biggest game of his club career, Ronaldo made his mark. He scored the opening goal in the final, and even though his night almost got ruined after missing a penalty in the shootout, United still held firm. And at the end of the night, Ronaldo was celebrating the first of many. He'd won the Champions League with Manchester United. He didn't just win it, he was voted the best player in the competition, and finished that Champions League campaign with his first Champions League Golden Boot Award. The following season wasn't as productive for Ronaldo, but even with that, he still managed to pop up with bangers like this. United managed to get to another final, especially thanks to a Ronaldo masterclass performance versus Arsenal in the second leg of the semis. He directly contributed to every goal United scored that evening, 2 goals and 1 assist. Ultimately, in the final though, Ronaldo and United came second best. Ronaldo's final appearance for United in the Champions League under Sir Alex, a few weeks later, was all set for a new chapter. But unknowingly to Ronaldo, he was about to enter the dark days of his Champions League career. When Ronaldo joined Real Madrid in the summer of 2009, they'd gone 7 seasons since they last won the trophy. And the idea was that Ronaldo would be the guy to help bring La Décima home. Ronaldo wasted no time in getting off the mark for Madrid in the competition. He scored on his Champions League debut. He followed this up with a second goal later on, and another brace versus Marseille. An ankle injury kept him out of both games versus AC Milan. He scored another 2 in the away game versus Marseille to make it 6 goals in 4 Champions League games for Madrid. Incredible start. But unfortunately, Ronaldo couldn't break the jinx. Madrid was knocked out in the round of 16, the 3rd time in 5 years. Unfortunately, this became the trend over the next 2 seasons that followed. Ronaldo was playing well individually and racking up the goals too. 6 goals and 4 assists in the 2010-11 season, 10 goals and 3 assists in 2011-12, and 2012-13, he finally bagged his first hat trick in the competition. Finished that season with 12 goals and 1 assist in 12 games. The second consecutive season his goal tally was matching his number of games played in the competition. And yet, no silverware to show for it. That same season, Ronaldo won his 2nd Champions League Top Scorer Award. And while he hadn't won the competition with Madrid yet, he was already cementing his status as a legend. This goal against Dortmund in the semi-finals was his 50th in the competition, 2013-14, and this, guys, was where we started to see just how much of a beast Ronaldo is. In the group stages of the Champions League that year, Ronaldo had notched up a record of 9 goals in 6 games. No one else had reached that tally. He began the campaign with a hat trick against Galatasaray. Scored braces against Copenhagen and Juventus. He scored in all 5 group stage matches he played in. In the round of 16 versus Schalke, he scored braces home and away, including 2 assists in the first leg, scored in the quarterfinal first leg versus Borussia Dortmund, and after going 2 games without a goal, in the semi-final second leg versus Bayern Munich, Ronaldo was at it again. A brace against Bayern at the Allianz Arena, including this stunning free kick. Real Madrid was in a Champions League final for the first time since 2002. The first time in Ronaldo's career he'd been playing for Los Blancos in the final, they almost lost, but Sergio Ramos scored a stoppage time equalizer to draw Madrid level. Then, Bale and Marcelo scored to make it 3-1. Even though he'd already made the assist for Marcelo's goal, Ronaldo knew this night wouldn't be complete if he hadn't scored yet. And right before the end, he made history. 17 Champions League goals in 11 games, 5 assists, a record no one has managed to beat. He wasn't only the Champions League top scorer, he was also voted as the best player in the competition. The 2014-15 season was a mixed bag. On one hand, Ronaldo scored 10 Champions League goals that season to finish as the joint top scorer, but Real Madrid couldn't defend their crown. Instead, it was Barcelona who did a treble that season. It's almost as if this got to him and gave him a new level to his game, because in the next 3 seasons, it officially became the UEFA Cristiano League. History once again. Ronaldo's hat trick against Shakhtar Donetsk made him the all-time top scorer in the competition's history with 80 goals, and from that moment on, he went on a tear. He added another 2 versus Malmo, and recorded 8 goals and 3 assists from match day 5 of the group stage to the round of 16. The beautiful thing about Ronaldo's Champions League goals that year was that they came when Madrid needed them. They'd lost to Wolfsburg in the first leg of the quarterfinal. The second leg? Ronaldo 3-2 Wolfsburg sent Madrid to the semis. He finished that campaign with 12 goals, including scoring the crucial penalty to seal a 12th Champions League title for Los Blancos. Champions League top scorer for the fourth time. But in 2016-17, Ronaldo's ability to perform in Europe's biggest competition was under threat. After scoring in the opening two group stage games, he failed to score in the next six. Mentally, though, he didn't change. It was his competition, and he was about to show everyone why. The brace didn't just give Madrid a 2-1 away win versus Bayern Munich, it gave Ronaldo history too. Goals number 99 and 100. The first player to reach 100 goals in the Champions League. Amazing. Ronaldo, though, still wasn't done. Just to give you an idea of what the golden boot race was at the time, Ronaldo had only scored 4 goals in the competition up to that point. At the end of the campaign, he finished with 12. How? Back-to-back hat-tricks versus Bayern Munich and Atletico Madrid, including another 2 in the final versus Juventus. He became the first player to score in 3 Champions League finals, the Champions League top scorer for the 5th straight season, 6th overall. Everything he did was record-breaking. In the 2017-18 season, Ronaldo picked up where he left off. He scored in every group stage game against the likes of Borussia Dortmund and Tottenham, scored in both home and away against PSG in the round of 16. But his best moment of the competition came in the quarterfinal first leg versus Juventus. He'd already scored early on to give Juve the lead, but his second goal stunned the stadium. In the words of Andrea Barzagli, that was a PlayStation goal. Ronaldo came clutch in the second leg too. This penalty sent Real Madrid through 4-3 on aggregate, and even though he didn't score again, it was still enough to take home a 6th straight Champions League top scorer award. The end of an era. Ronaldo left Madrid to join Juventus that season, and in truth, it wasn't the move both he and the club had hoped it would be. Ronaldo scored 14 times for Juventus, including that memorable hat-trick versus Atletico Madrid in the round of 16. Knocked them out again! However, they soon parted ways 3 years later. Ronaldo was back home in Manchester, and he rolled back the years in the Champions League wearing red. 6 goals in 5 group stage games, he scored in every game he played in. That was where Ronaldo's Champions League journey ended. He's since gone to Al Nassr, but his record in the competition remains insane. He has the most appearances in the competition with 183, the most goals in the competition with 140, the most goals in a single Champions League season, the most Champions League final wins, the only player to score in 11 straight Champions League games, most goals in the Champions League knockout stage, most goals in Champions League finals. Pretty sure you get the idea. The man owns the competition. Hit that subscribe button in the Goal Zone if you enjoyed this one.